Good day, everybody. In this video, I would like to explain how we can estimate changes in the vertical stress when we apply a point load to the soil mass. Let's look at this schematic diagram. So here we have soil elements at depth of Z. And then we're going to apply a force to this point, P. And we would like to estimate what is going to be the change in the vertical stress, delta sigma Z. So to do that, we are going to use this equation. So this the solution of Boussinesq. He proposed it in 1883, but he proposed it for a homogeneous, elastic, and isotropic medium, which, as you may know, soil mass cannot be. Soil mass is not elastic and it's not homogeneous in the real life, in the field. But we are going to assume that soil mass can be all these three, especially if the force that we apply is not very high. So in this case, we can still use this equation to estimate changes in the vertical stress. And you see that here we're going to estimate only change in the vertical stress. So to estimate the change, we would like to know the force. And let's assume that we apply force of 10 kilonewtons, right? So it's just a point load in one point. And what we need to know is what is the depth of the soil element. So what is the Z? And let's assume that it's 3 meters. Another thing that we would like to know is the distance of this soil element from this point P. So in this case, we are going to use X and Y. So that will give you approximately the distance where we have soil element at this point. So let's assume that y will be 3 meters. It's just example. And x will be equal to 2 meters. So now we're going to estimate the change in the vertical stress. We use this equation. You see that in this equation, we have this component, which is called I1. And this is just depends on the characteristics of this soil element. So how far is from the point P? So you will see that the only thing that we will need to find is R, and we already know Z. So to find this R, we use this formula. And let's do it right now. So we're going to say that R is equal square root of x in the power of 2. So it will be 2 in the power of 2 plus, and y, we assume it's 3 meters, to right? So that will give us approximately 3.61. Okay. So now we can just put it in the formula. So that's one way to solve this problem. And the second one, I'm going to show you graphical solution, which is shown here in the diagram. So it will be I1, it's equal 3 divided by 2 times pi. For pi, I'm going to use 3.14159 to 6. I think that should be enough. Then times 1, here we have R divided by Z. So if we use R divided by Z, it will be 3.61. And Z, we assume, was 3 meters. So that's the assumption we made for this problem. So that will give us 1.202. Right? So it's kind of like simple math. So now we're going to put here is 1.202 in the power of 2 plus 1, and this has this kind of funny power of 5 over 2. So according to my calculations, this value of I should be equal to 0.0511. And now we can estimate that change in the vertical stress, so delta sigma Z, it's equal P, which is 10 kilonewtons, divided by the depth of the soil element, which is 3 meters in the power of 2, and then times this I component, which is 0.0511, and that will give us answer of approximately 0.057 kilonewton per square meters. So that will be increase in the vertical stress for this soil element if we apply a point load force here P, which is kind of quite far from the soil element. So now I'm going to show you how we can also use this graphical solution. So what I did before, I drew this curve. So I change R over Z, so I started from 0, then 0.1, 0.2, and I put these numbers in this formula, and I estimated this value I1. So because you see this value I1 just like depends on R and Z, that's how they change. So I came up with this curve. And instead of doing this calculation, so instead of calculate I, what I did here, you can still do that. I can just look at the graph. And if I know that R over Z, it's 1.202, was going to be somewhere 1.1, 1.2, somewhere a little bit here. So that gives us a point of I1. And that should be 0.02, 0.04. So that should be around 0.05. Well, maybe it's not as accurate as the calculation, but it still gives you a very, very similar value. That's what you need to estimate change in the vertical stress. Okay, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something new. Thanks, and have a nice day. Bye.